I remember a couple of days prior to the actual event, you know, forecasting for, and just it seemed, obviously, as we got closer to the event, it became evident and just clear that this was going to be different than any other severe weather event we had ever covered. I actually remember being in a meeting with management and with Chief Meteorologist Jerry Tracy, and we had obviously been in a lot of meetings leading up to the event. And I remember one member of management said, "Listen, we're tired of hearing about all of the weather and the forecasting. Just tell me how bad it's going to be." And Jerry looked at him and said, "It's going to be historic. This will be a historic event." And I remember that so clearly, because I don't think I really grasped, and I don't think any of us really grasped what he meant by that, and I don't think he even understood. You know, a lot of people lost power during that time, during those morning storms, which then had consequences for the round later in the day too. I think since April 27th, I really do think people take the weather more seriously. I think you have to. I think a lot of people, April 27th was kind of a defining moment as far as Alabamians are concerned. A lot of times you'll describe things that happened prior to April 27th or things that happened after April 27th. But I think since that event, people know how serious it can be, and we may never see another April 27th here in central Alabama, but I think all it takes is one. All it takes is one EF3, EF4, or EF5 at your house, and that is your April 27th. This severe weather season was definitely supposed to be more active, and so far it's already held true. I mean, we've had multiple events. We've had two high-risk severe weather events, which, I've only had or forecasted a handful of high-risk severe weather events in my 20-plus years of forecasting weather, and we've had two of those already this year. So it's definitely been a lot more active. I think the one important thing that people, when it comes to severe weather, if they are able to see the severe weather, if they're able to see the tornadoes like we see a lot more of nowadays, just because of obviously technology, they take it a lot more seriously. And I think seeing the tornadoes on April 27th and how many there were, how huge they were, I mean, those were monster tornadoes. I remember thinking as they were happening and live on the air and we were showing them, I remember thinking what a monster tornado that was that came through Tuscaloosa, but that there were people that were not going to survive this tornado. There were people that were not going to live through this tornado, and there was nothing we could do about it. WVTM 13 Live Doppler has a huge advantage now. You know, we can track those supercell tornadic thunderstorms live and in real time, and every minute counts. Every minute that you have to be able to get into your safe place, it counts. It's helpful. Those supercells were moving 50 to 60 miles an hour. So when you're tracking something that fast, having a live radar image is huge. It's everything. I go through Cahaba Heights a lot, and you know, the morning round came through Cahaba Heights, completely changed the landscape. All of the trees are gone. You know, Cahaba Heights used to be full of trees, and the landscape is completely different. And that's true of a lot of places. It will never look the same. People's lives will never be the same. There are so many ways that you can get weather information. There are so many ways that you can get alerts and that you can get warnings, and you just have to do it. And you have to act. When a warning is issued, you can't just ignore it and say, "Oh, I just ignored it." You know, it's issued for a reason. I think the biggest thing that people have to understand is that you have to act.